Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's going to be a review on a newer foundation release. I believe this foundation has been out for maybe about a month now. The only downside is, I know a lot of you guys will probably be annoyed at me for this, but luckily it's going to be coming back in stock eventually. But whenever this foundation launched, I believe the email said that they were kind of like guessing around like 25,000 orders, but it ended up being like 250,000 orders. My order even ended up being, I think, back ordered for like 3 to 4 weeks. It took a while to get to me. I don't think that that's like their normal schedule. But the email was like super sincere and apologetic. So yeah, just so you guys know, you can go onto the Deciem website, and if you do end up wanting to get this foundation after seeing the review, they do have a little button where you can click to email to get a notification whenever they do come back in stock. Trust me, if you're like me and you like this type of formula that I'm about to explain to you guys, I really think that you're gonna wanna go ahead and sign up for that just because it's such an amazing foundation. So as I've already discussed, I did get the product from Deciem.com. I believe that's how you pronounce it. So the actual product that I'm talking about is the new foundation, or I guess the colors line launched by the brand The Ordinary. That name sounds familiar. They've recently kind of like taken over the skincare realm. They have so many amazing skincare products. I only have two so far. I really wanna get on there and try more, but a lot of the best sellers are currently sold out, and that's because the entire line is so incredibly affordable. So this is the line, the colors. There's two different foundation formulas available. There's the serum foundation, which is the only one that I have currently. Whenever I went on, the coverage foundation was sold out just because that one is supposed to be a full-on, full coverage foundation, and I believe that that's the one that Wayne Goss had demonstrated, so that one like sold out basically instantly. I saw that video and I like immediately went onto the site and ordered. So I got mine in the serum foundation, which honestly just spoke more to me anyways. Just because if you guys are familiar with my channel, I tend to go with more like lightweight, natural to medium coverage foundations, or at least like medium that can be buildable. So I grabbed two shades. It just says lightweight serum formula. I grabbed 2.0N and then 2.1Y. There's 21 shades total. I'm not sure for the coverage foundation. I believe it's the same, but in today's video, we're just going to be talking about the serum foundation. So they broke it down really nicely. Basically, all the shades that start with 1 are going to kind of be your light range. 2 is your light to medium, and then 3 is going to be your deeper and darker shades. Then it's also broken down into N, which is neutral, Y, which is yellow, and then I think R and P for red and pink. And then there's also two additional shades, I think it was like G and S, something that kind of has like gold and silver tones for more of like a multi-effect type of like highlighting metallic finish, I guess. I don't have any of those, but I can already tell you as soon as these come back in stock, because I like went ahead and put in multiple email notifications for several shades, this formula is hands down one of my like all-time favorite foundations now. Ever since I ordered it, I have not been able to stop wearing it. It is so, so comfortable, especially if you live somewhere hot and humid. I am in Texas, in Houston to be exact. I am going to be including a application video as well, but that was applied I think 4-5 hours ago now. I applied that around noon. It's 5:25, so like 5 hours and 30 minutes. It says it's 89 degrees, but it feels like 101. The humidity is at like 66%. It is so hot and muggy out. Like my hair started off being like big and bodacious, and now it's just like flat and disgusting. And as you can see, this foundation has held up. The formula is just amazing. It's so weightless and just feels amazing on the skin. I do have my monitor pulled up right here just to read a couple of the facts about the foundation. So I already mentioned there's 21 shades. The best part about this foundation is it's $6.70. You get 1 fluid ounce, so it's the normal amount of foundation, but it's under $10 and it's freaking amazing. Okay, so the pH, if you guys were curious, the range is from 6 to 8.25. It's alcohol-free, oil-free, nut-free, vegan, gluten-free, soy-free, and cruelty-free. The way that they describe the coverage, which I completely agree with, is weightless medium coverage formulations. You'll see whenever I apply two different weights to kind of amp up the coverage even more. It says these foundations offer moderate coverage that looks natural with a very lightweight serum feel. They are very low in viscosity and are dispensed with a supplied pump, or you can actually purchase a optional glass pump. The shade that I'm wearing right now is 2.0N. I think when I get a little bit darker, I could probably go in and mix some 2.1Y just because that definitely has a lot more yellow in it. But the shades, I would say, are pretty true to what you see online. Yeah, no, I would say that those look pretty similar. Okay, there was something else that I wanted to read about the pigments in here. It says the pigments used in this format are treated for a rich, highly saturated effect. They're suspended in our proprietary spreadability system that allows pigments to look natural on the skin. It resists collecting within fine lines and stay on for longer. And the foundations offer a semi-matte finish, which you'll see whenever I do the application demonstration. It definitely like kind of sets down to a very nice natural finish without being tacky. If you're really, really oily, you'll probably want to set it. But if you're more on the normal to dry side, it kind of just stays in place as is. I believe the coverage foundation does have more of a, like, not full on matte, but from what the reviews that I've seen and just the way that applies, it does look like it dries down a little bit more matte than this. So if you guys are curious of the difference between 2.0N and then here is 2.1Y. So there is pretty big jump. So I think the shade range is actually really good. That 21 shades, especially for such an affordable foundation. So the 2.1Y and then the 2.0N. Don't mind my disgust and scab over here. Formula, I honestly can't say enough about. If you're into lightweight, buildable, medium coverage, foundations that you don't really have to set, last throughout humidity. I don't think there's too many foundations these days at the drugstore under $10. I think the Rimmel one, Stay All Day something. I've talked about that foundation so many times. I think that one's even like the 680 to 670, 90 range. So pretty much similar to this. I just can't say enough about it. It's amazing. So as I mentioned, I got mine from Deciem.com. I believe you get free shipping if you spend over $25, which is honestly so easy because once you get on there and see the price range for the ordinary products, you're like, okay, I want to try this. I want to try this. I want to try this. So if you guys have any other recommendations from the line, The Ordinary, definitely leave them down below because I'm really wanting to try out more of their skincare. I know Beautylish sells The Ordinary, but I don't know if Colors has launched on there. So yeah, let's go ahead and jump into the application demo now. I feel like when my camera is this zoomed in, it just looks like I'm all forehead. Like my forehead just keeps going and going and going. But anyways, to start things off, as always, I went ahead and moisturized my face. For my primer today, I'm using this one from Pure. I've been loving this. This is the No Filter Blurring Photography Primer. It just has a nice little dropper and it just gives you this really nice kind of like iridescent effect. But as you can see, it's a thinner formula and it's kind of like the look of MAC Strobe Cream, but I feel like this has a little bit more like gold rather than like the typical white type of pearl finish, but it feels really nice on the skin. It's super lightweight and I feel like it gives you just that extra dew factor. So for my foundation today, I'm using the Ordinary Colors Light Coverage Serum Foundation. I have mine in the shade 2.0N, which is for neutral. So it says light, medium, neutral. As I mentioned earlier, at least I'm guessing so, I'm filming this part first, in the description of the foundation, this one comes in 21 shades. The only thing is this top part is kind of like the packaging of NARS, maybe not quite as rubberized, but it's that same thing where it kind of gets any little bits of fingerprints. I hate when like foundation is all over, so I'm constantly like wiping this off with a baby wipe or a makeup remover wipe just to keep it nice and clean. And then the actual bottle itself is plastic, which totally makes sense in my opinion, just because for $6, it's kind of silly to expect glass. Just the sound of it, as you can hear, it's super, super liquidy. So my favorite thing to do is just shake it up and then I just apply it onto the back of my hand. You could even do it in the palm of your hand, just because as you can see, it is super liquidy. I mean, that just like runs all over, but it feels amazing on the skin. So on one side, I'm going to show you how it applies just with fingers. And then on the other, I will use my sponge just because that's kind of my favorite way to apply it. I don't really like to even bother with a brush. You can, but just because it's so thin, I feel like it works great with your fingers or the sponge. Surprisingly enough, the sponge doesn't like soak it all in. It just does a really good job. Oh, I have like an eyeliner smudge on my face. Of pressing it right into the skin. It seriously feels like nothing is on, but the coverage is so, so pretty. Scent-wise, I'd say it's pretty much unscented. I don't really smell anything. You know, sometimes things will say it's unscented, but there's still this weird kind of like chemical smell. This one truly has zero scent. And you just pat it right into your skin, kind of like you would any other serum. So that is what it looks like with your fingers. Like I said, my favorite way, just because I have applied it every way, is with a sponge. So even after this, I'll still go in with a sponge. Whoa, that's my dog. Okay, so here is the side finished with my hand. Well, I guess not my whole side because I just did my cheek, because like I mentioned, I'm still going to go in with a beauty blender because I just feel like that gives the prettiest finish. So as you can see, my freckles are still peeking through, but it kind of just evened everything out. Whereas this side is still very, very just blotchy. Also, I picked my face right here don't do that. It looked like a crime scene. So I'm just going to take a teeny tiny bit more on the sponge and just press it onto my face. I don't know what it is with a sponge, but I feel like it does a great job of just pressing it into your skin. And I don't know how, but I swear it even kind of like blurs any texture. The formula of this is just absolutely amazing. I don't get how it's only $6 because it's so, so good. Here's what it looks like with a sponge. I feel like that's a big difference. It just kind of makes everything seamless. The color match is perfect. I absolutely love it. So here it is before and then after. Oh, seriously, such a pretty foundation. Okay, so here is all the foundation pressed into my skin. I'm still going to go in and apply concealer, set my under eyes, but everywhere else, I'm not going to set with powder. Since it does dry down to that semi-matte finish, I feel like I'm fine just applying bronzer on top without having to apply a setting powder first and, like, you know, having the bronzer catch onto the foundation. It's already drying down. It has, like, the slightest bit of tackiness, but in about 3 to 5 minutes, it'll be completely dry. It's so thin and honestly just, like, melts right into your skin. I just don't really worry about doing setting powder. Unless you're someone who's really, really oily, I probably would go ahead on your like forehead and your nose to set it. I really wish I had the coverage foundation just to compare, but that one was sold out when I went online. So now I'm just gonna go ahead, apply my concealer, my blush, my bronzer, and I will be right back. All right, y'all, so that is it for this video. I really hope you guys found it helpful. If you happen to already pick up this product, let me know what your thoughts are down below. I also recently picked up the new CoverGirl foundation, the Vitalist, Healthy Elixir Vitalist. I know there's already lots of reviews on that, but if you guys would like to see one, let me know down below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will catch you in the next one. Bye.